Okay, a very good morning, children. Children, in the previous class, we discussed the graph of linear equation in two variable. And there, after drawing the graph, I said what is the nature of the graph of a linear equation in two variable, which is of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. It is always a what? Straight line. It will always be a straight line. Okay, now children, you see, and I also said that every point lying on the line, on the graph, whatever line you will get, any point lying on the graph, that is the straight line, is a solution of the given equation. Okay. Now the question is, suppose, now let us consider some other cases. Suppose you are given a point. Okay, suppose you are given a point, say whose coordinates are 1 and 2, and you have to find equation of a line. That means find equation of a line which passes through this point. 1 and 2. The coordinates of the point are 1 and 2. How to find what will be the equation of the line? Okay. See, here the x coordinate is 1 and y coordinate is 2. X coordinate of the point is 1, y coordinate of the point is 2. So, what will be one line? What will be the possible line? And how many such lines are possible? That means, how many such lines are possible which can pass through this point? You know, through one point, we know that through a given point, we can draw infinitely many lines. You see, these are infinitely many lines which can pass through a given point. If this point is say 1 and 2, so these are, we can draw infinitely many lines. So how to get such lines? Okay. Now see, if x coordinate is 1, you see, if x coordinate of the point is 1 and y coordinate of the point is 2, so one line, you see, equation of a line may be, you see, if we write x plus 2y, you see, the value of x is 1, the value of y is 2. So x plus 2y, 1 plus 2 into, you see, 1 plus 2 into 2, that is 4, you see. Therefore, x plus 2y equal to 4 will be one line, which will definitely pass through the point 1 and 2. So the point whose coordinates are 1 and 2. Now see children, can we write in this manner? Suppose y minus x, you see, y minus x, what will be y minus x? It will be 2 minus 1, that is 1, you see, y minus x. So y minus x, this is one line, you see. Now this is one line. So like this, we can find infinitely many lines through a given point, and it is also true because we know through a given point we can draw infinite number of lines. Okay, so even okay, you can say sir, y equal to 2x, you see, y equal to 2x, that means y, the value of y is what? Y equal to 2x, you see, if we take y equal to 2x, that means in place of y we will put 2 in place of x, you see, y equal to 2x, y equal to 2x, or y minus 2x equal to 0, you see, and it is clearly true. In place of y, you put 2, in place of x, you put 1. So y minus 2x equal to 0, it is another line. So, like this, we can find many lines passing through a given point. Okay. So, now, children, the geometrical interpretation, what I said, the geometrical interpretation, you see, the geometrical interpretation of a linear equation in two variables. And the geometrical interpretation of a linear equation in one variable. You see, this is the general equation of linear, this is the general form of a linear equation in one variable, this is the general form of a linear equation in two variables. Now, if you represent both these equations graphically, the graph of both equations will be what? Straight line. Okay? Now, let us consider a special case. Suppose y equal to, you see, y equal to mx. You see, what will be the graph of y equal to mx, where m is some constant and y and x are variable. Okay, so what will be the graph of this? Now if you draw the graph of this, the graph of this will be, you see, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. Okay, now if you draw the graph of this, you will find that it is always a straight line. You see, it will be a straight line passing through the origin. This will be the graph of y equal to mx or y equal to kx. Any linear equation in two, this is also a linear equation in two variable. So here m is some constant. For example, you see, suppose y equal to, example I am taking, y equal to 2x. You see, suppose m equal to 2. If you draw the graph of y equal to 2x, I told you yesterday in the previous class how to draw the graph of linear equation in two variable. This is also a linear equation in two variable, because you see y equal to 2x means 2x minus y equal to 0. Here the value of a is 2, value of b is minus 1, and the value of c is 0. Okay, so it is of the form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Hence it is a linear equation in two variable. And if you draw the graph of this linear equation in two variable, which is of the form y equal to mx, you will find it is a straight line passing through the origin. You can easily verify by taking different values. You see, what we discussed yesterday, suppose x and y, suppose x equal to 0, you see x equal to 0, so what will y? 2 into 0, 0, x equal to 1, y will be equal to 2 into 1, 2, x equal to 2, y will be 4. Now you see, draw these points in the Cartesian plane. You see, if you draw these ordered pairs, 0, 0, 1, 2, 2, 4, if these three ordered pairs are plotted on the Cartesian plane by taking suitable scale, you will find a straight line. You will get a straight line like this, which will definitely pass through the origin. Okay, so any linear equation in two variable which is of the form y equal to mx or y equal to kx, where k is some constant, is always a straight line which passes through the origin. Okay, so now let us discuss some problems on linear equation in one variable. Okay, now after this, let me discuss few problems on linear equation in one variable. Suppose there is a question, you see. So I told you how to find infinite number of lines passing through a given point. That means if you are given the coordinates of a point, infinite number of lines can pass through it, and how to find the equation of those lines, I just told you now. Okay, let us solve some problems. Okay, suppose you are given a point, give the equation of two lines passing through 2 and 14. You see, give equation of two lines, that means you have to give the equation of two lines passing through the point, say 2 and 14. See, 2 and 14, yes, 2 and 14 is a point whose coordinates are 2 and 14. The x coordinate is 2, y coordinate is 14. How you find equation of two lines? Just now I said one through one example. So how to find equation of two lines which passes through this point? As I said just now, through a given point we can draw many lines, infinite number of lines. Let us find two lines passing through this point. You see, how to get? What is the value of x here? 2. What is the value of y here? 14. So one equation may be x plus y equal to 2 plus 14, that is 16, you see. So x plus y equal to 16, it is one linear equation in two variable passing through this point. Because 2 and 14 satisfying this equation, you see. If the values of 2 and 14 are put here, then this equation is satisfied. So definitely this is a line passing through this point. Okay. Suppose I will take y minus x, it is 14 minus 2, it is 7, you see, this is another line. So in this way, you can find several lines. You can find infinite number of lines passing through this point. Okay. So from this, we came to conclude that through a given point, we can draw infinite number of what? Lines. We can draw as many lines as we like through this given point. Okay. You can say, sir, y equal to, you see, suppose y equal to 2x, you see, y equal to 2x. Y equal to 2x means, you see, what is the value of x? X is 2. Y, you see. So 2x minus y equal to 2x minus y. 2x minus y means 2 into 2 minus y equal to 2x. 2x minus y. 2x minus y means 2 into 2 minus y is 14. You see. 4 minus 14, it is minus 10. This is another equation. See. Equation of line. 2x minus y equal to minus 10. And it is true, because you see, put here, in place of x you put 2, 2 to the 4, minus interest of y is 14. 4 minus 14 is minus 10. Minus 10. So 2x minus y equal to minus 10. It can be one equation of line also, which passes through the point 2 and 14. Okay. So in this way, you can determine so many lines, infinite number of lines, which passes through a given point. Okay, children, I hope you understood. Next, we will discuss in another class. See, children, in another class, we will discuss geometric representation. Suppose you are given a linear equation in one variable. How to represent it both? I mean, in two variable and one variable. What will be the geometric representation? That we are going to discuss in another class. I hope you understood this much. How to find infinite number of lines passing through a given point. Okay, let us do another problem. Okay, let us do another problem. Suppose a question is given, you see. Suppose a question is given, if the point 3, 4 lies, you see, if 3, 4, this is a point whose coordinates are 3 and 4, lies on the graph, line is given, graph of equation 3y equal to ax plus 7. See, children, this is a linear equation in two variable. Okay, now what is the question? The question is this point whose coordinates are 3 and 4. If you draw the graph of this, as I have already told you, if we draw the graph of any linear equation in two variable, we will always get a straight line. Okay, now if this point lies on the graph of this, that means if the point 3 and 4 lies on the straight line, which is the graph of this equation, then what will be the value of A? Find, here is A, you see, here A. What will be the value of A? A is a constant. What will be the value of A? See, children, how to do this one? How to solve this type of question, okay? A point whose coordinates are 3 and 4, it is lying on the graph of this linear equation in two variable. Okay, children, I have yesterday while discussing the graph of linear equation in two variable, I had said one thing. I hope you must have remembered. Any point lying on the straight line or any point lying on the graph of the linear equation in two variable must satisfy that linear equation. So since 3, 4, how to do that? Since 3, the point 3, 4 lies on the graph of 3y equal to ax plus 7. Therefore, it must satisfy, you see, it must satisfy the line, equation of the line. This point must satisfy the equation of the line. What does it mean? That means, this point, if we put in this equation of line, the left side, right side will become equal. Okay. So, now since it satisfies the line or equation of line, therefore, now put the value. This is the x coordinate, this is the y coordinate of the point. So, in place of x you put 4, in place of x you put 3, in place of y you put 4. So, what will you get? You see, 3 into 4 equal to a into 3 plus 7. Very simple now. 3, 4 is 12. 12 minus 7 is 12 minus 7 is 3a. So a will be equal to 5 by 3. See, children. So the value of a will be 5 by 3. When this point, whose coordinates are 3 and 4, lie on this graph of this equation or line, the value of a will be equal to 5 by 3. Okay. So in this way, children, you will solve any problem. So basically, in this chapter, what we discussed? A linear equation in two variable has infinitely many solutions. How to find those infinite solutions? Yesterday I told you. Okay, by taking any value of x, you will get another value of y. And that order pair x and y will satisfy the equation of the line. So that is the solution. Okay, then if you draw the graph, graphically, if you draw the graph, whatever points lie on the line, all the points lying on the line will be, every point lying on the line will be a solution of that particular equation. Okay, linear equation in two variable. Okay. Now, another thing, if you are given a point, how to determine infinite number of lines? If you are given the coordinates of a point, how to find infinite number of lines? I discussed. And this is another type of problem. If a point lies on the line or equation of graph of the equation of line in two variable, then how to get the value of a, k, a, whatever the constant may be. If the constant is a, in questions you may get the constant n, n, k, etc., etc. How to get, how to determine the value of the constant? If a point lies on a line, I just told you what is the process, okay? Then another thing I said, how to draw the graph of what? A linear equation in two variables which is of the form y equal to what? Mx or y equal to kx, where m is some constant. These are the things. Now the last part of this chapter we will discuss in another class so that it will come to an end. Okay, I hope children you understood. Thank you.